lamellosus of TI. That isn't right. I have eliminated that. Here's what this is. I was using this, but of course, if you go down there, you'll see that this was put together with that. And what is here is wherever I put that together with that. I don't even see where that was done. Oh, well, this is where we made our approximation, that HGA, here we said HGA over M water, P, K, PA, is approximately CS. That turned that term into, I don't want that lambda zero there anymore. I don't want that, I do want PKPA. Okay, HLA, I like it. M water, not lambda zero, KLA, times HGI minus HG. This has got to be true. This tells me that points whose coordinates are TL and HG are related to points whose coordinates are TI and HGI by drawing a straight line. So I look at that equation down there and I say, hey, look at that, would you? That equation tells me that if I have a TL and an HG at some point on here, here it is right here, a TL and an HG, I can go find the corresponding point, TI, HGI. And I do that by going to that point, this point right here, and drawing a line of slope, molecular weight is moles per KL, it looks good. A line of slope, how am I doing this? I'm going to say, I'm going to solve this for, say, HGI. Okay, I'll solve this for HGI. HGI equals HG plus or minus something. KLA over M, HLA. Molecular weight of water, P, KPA, times, and I guess there's a minus sign in there. Okay, a minus sign, TI minus TL. So I go to the point whose coordinates are TL and HG, and I draw a line of slope minus this number, and I get all the points where TI and HGI must lie. So I go draw this line. But I know they have to lie on that curve. So I'm drawing a line here of slope. It looks like from here minus HGA over the molecular weight of water times PKPA. And so I say to myself, I'm all set. For any TL and HG, I can locate the point whose coordinates are TI and HGI, and that difference right there is HGI minus HG. So this, every point along here I draw this line, every point along here I draw this line, every point along here I have this difference in enthalpies between there and there. That difference in enthalpies is what I got to deal with, so I plot my usual graph, 1 over this versus HG, and I do the integration, I have the height of the thing. Okay? It's a calculation you might not want to do every day, but nonetheless. Okay, now, I told you March 30 was a great day. Here's what's great about it. I'm walking out and I'm not coming back. So you've got three tests left, one today, right? And I think there's all three are on packed columns. I'm pretty sure, yeah, all three are on packed columns. I don't even know what they are. So you'll take three more tests. That'll be 11 tests. 11 tests make sense to me.
Are you going to drop one?
Are you going to drop one?
Drop one? What would you have guessed I would have said?
Yes.
11's a weird number. Make it 10.
I'll make it 12 if you want. We still have another Wednesday. That didn't go over too good. Okay, so we'll average 10 and 12 and get 11.
You're so generous.
I don't know what that means.
Here's the thing. I have a nice place to work out there. Nobody bothers me. I get a lot done. If you get questions about these packed columns, you're trying to work problems and so forth, come by, ask me the questions. I'll answer them. Or VJ will undoubtedly answer them. And VJ will probably, you can even ask VJ if he wants to move those. Oh, he can't. He's already given them. No, you can move the test up an hour, can't you? Since I'm not going to be here. Why don't you ask VJ if he wants to move the test up an hour? And
what?
Don't be so hungry.
So move it, what, I don't know, start it at 4?
Yeah. Wouldn't you prefer that? Okay, guys, good luck. Thank you.